Very good morning, students. Welcome all of you to this YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn a new lesson from a new subject. Before that, let me introduce myself. I am Shalini Kuldeep Singh Bhadauria from KL Mehra UBS English Primary School. Today we are going to learn one interesting lesson from the textbook Shiv Chhatrapati Environmental Studies Part 2. Before that, I would like to ask you some questions. I hope you all are attentive. Yes? All are attentive? All right, very good. The first question goes, when did Shivaji's education begin? This we have done in the previous lessons.
Shivaji's attitude began when he became 7 years old.
Very good. Very nice, Aditi. So we see that Shivaji's education began when he became 7 years old. Like how you go to first standard when you are grown up. Similarly, his education also began at very early age. Second question is, who appointed teachers for Shivaji Maharaj?
Shahaji Raje has appointed teacher for Shivaji.
Very good. Shahaji Raje, the father of Shivaji Maharaj, appointed different teachers for Shivaji Maharaj and for his education. Now, can you tell me who used to tell stories to Shivaji Maharaj?
Jijabai.
Yes. Shivaji's mother, Jijabai, used to tell him stories. So his education was very much acquainted with the other things also. He learned so many things. What knowledge did Shivaji acquire? Can you give some hint about it? What kind of knowledge he's acquired?
Dhanpatta, Talwar, horses and elephants.
Collection of horse and elephants based of excamping from different enemy studies.
Okay. Anybody else want to try? Very nice, Ishika and Aditi.
Select of horse and elephant.
Okay. Very nice. See, he learned about swordsmanship. He learned Danpatta. He learned how to find out the good horses and elephants for the war purpose. Very nice. So we'll see. He acquired the knowledge of excellent administration. He also learned various war tactics. Fort architecture means how to build a fort for the defense purpose. And he also learned how to select good horses and elephants for the war. And last but not the least, different ways of escaping from the enemy territories. These all things, all the knowledge was acquired by Shivaji Maharaj at a very early age. In this picture, you can see Shivaji Maharaj is taking blessings from Shahaji Maharaj. And another picture, there is a royal seal, which we have seen in the previous lesson. We'll know about it in detail. The Jagir was already being administered in the name of Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji Raje had cast a special royal seal for Shivaji. Here you can see that seal is here. And it is written, Pratipachya Dralekhe Vavardhishnuri Swavandita Sahasa No Shiveshya Mudra Bhadraya Rajate. Okay, can anybody tell me what language is this?
Marathi, Sanskrit.
Okay.
Sanskrit.
Correct. It is Sanskrit language, and as we all know, Shahaji was a great scholar of Sanskrit. So he cast a royal seal for Shivaji Maharaj in Sanskrit language. Now we'll see what is the meaning of this royal seal. It reads as, the seal will grow in splendor like the new moon. The seal of Shivaji, the son of Shahaji, receiving homage from the whole world denotes the welfare of the people. So we can see that the royal seal in a way foretold the foundation of Swaraj. It was just the beginning that Shivaji is going to establish a wonderful Swaraj in the guidance of Shahaji Maharaj. So today's our lesson is also based on the same thing, Swaraj, first conquest. When did Shivaji start with the Swaraj establishment? It is no doubt true that Shivaji and his comrades took the oath of Swaraj in the temple of Raireshwar. But it was a very difficult task. Now, why it was difficult? Because Maharashtra was governed by four different powers. During the time of Shivaji Maharaj, there were four different powers who governed the Maharashtra. We see that powers are Mughal Emperor of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, the Portuguese of Goa, and the Siddhi of Janjira. These are the four powers that governed Maharashtra during the time of Shivaji Maharaj. And it was very difficult to tackle them because they were very much powerful. Why they were powerful? The reasons are they were very firm in their authority. No one would dare utter a word against them because they were so powerful, nobody was going against them. And the third reason is they had vast forces and a very huge army. So nobody thought of going against them because they were very powerful in so many ways. During that time, Shivaji controlled the Jagir of Pune, Supe, Chakan, and Indapur Parganas. All the forts in the Jagir were, however, in the charge of officers from the court of Bijapur of Adil Shah. Now, the Jagir was in the control of Shivaji Maharaj, but the forts, they were not in control of Shivaji Maharaj. The forts were all under the control of Adil Shah. But a hill fort gives a strategic support to the ruler, and Shivaji decided to capture the one at a suitable time. Because the king, who is having a fort under him, can be present as a strategic support for him. For this purpose, he has chosen a fort named as Torana Fort. Now we will see what are the characteristics, features of Torana Fort. It stands to the southwest Pune in the Kanad Valley. It was renowned fort, well suited for defense. Means it is good for hiding purpose. It is a very difficult passage with high hills on one side and deep valleys on the other side. Like it is very difficult to walk on such place. A careless person may easily lose his balance and end his life in a deep valley. One side, there are high hills, and on the other sides, there is a deep valley. So a person has to be very much careful if he is walking on the Torana Fort. And it was also considered one of the strongest fort in Maharashtra. So it was Shivaji's plan to capture the Torana Fort at first. In the Torana Fort, there were two machis. Now, what is machis? As you can see in this picture, it is a natural fortification. The first picture is the Junzar Machi and the other picture is the Budla Machi. A machi is a fortification of a natural plateau formed on the slope of a hill. It is a fortification which is formed on the hill. One of these machis was the Junzar Machi and the other was the Budla Machi. The only access to the fort was across the Junzar Machi. In that Torana Fort, there was temple of goddess Toranzai. Because of that, the fort was named as Torana Fort. During that time, Adil Shah was very much careless. Now, in what way he was careless, we'll see here. The Torana Fort was very much powerful, but it was neglected by Adil Shah. There were neither enough troops for its defense and not enough ammunition. Like, there were no soldiers on this Torana fort to guard it. And there were not enough ammunitions, means weapons to fight with. Shivaji knew this, and this was exactly what he wanted. It was very much easier for Shivaji Maharaj to capture the Torana fort because there were very less troops, soldiers, and nothing enough ammunitions. He decided to capture the fort and thus lay the foundation of Hindavi Swaraj. With the new selected band of Mavlas, Shivaji descended into the Kanad Valley, swift-footed like the deer, and lion-hearted in courage. They raced to the top and captured the strategic position in the fort. Now, swift-footed like a deer, like when the deer walks, you cannot make sound of its noise. It walks very swiftly, so you cannot make it the noise. And lion-hearted means very brave. All the Mavlas, all the soldiers in Shivaji's place were very much brave and courageous. So along with them, Shivaji captured the strategic position in the fort. Tanaji Malasore hoisted the Maratha flag at the main entrance. Yeshaji Kang, a trustworthy and a loyal companion of Shivaji, posted his guards at important points. The fort was captured almost without any resistance, and the sky was filled with the shouts of Shivaji Maharaj ki jai. Everywhere the sound echoed, and everybody was praising Shivaji Maharaj for his huge success. Now, later on, when he captured the fort, he named this fort Prachandagarh. The meaning of Prachand is very huge, and that converted into Hindi, that is Prachandagarh, or in Marathi. Now, the next important thing was administration of Torana fort, because the Adil Shah already did not administer it properly. So it was Shivaji's duty that once he's captured the fort, he should administer the Torana fort very well. So for that purpose, he made very careful survey and appointed officers such as Maratha Kiledar, a Brahmin Sabnes, and a Prabhu Karkhanes to look after the administration of the Torana fort. The garrison included Mavlas, Kolis, Romshis, Mahars, and such brave men from many other castes and communities. As we can see, Mavlas, Kolis, Romshis and Mahars, they come from the different strata of the society. Like some belong to lower caste, some belong to upper caste. But Shivaji did not make any distinction in the lower and upper caste, as it was taught by our great saints that we should not discriminate according to the caste of people, according to how rich and how poor they are. Same thing Shivaji learned, and he included all the people from different caste and communities and did not make any distinctions on the basis of caste. Now, what do you think? From where did he got this gold? People say that it is a gift to Shivaji from goddess Bhavani. Now, what happened? When the repairs of the fort were going on, there was a surprise. In that fort, they discovered 4 metal pots filled to the brim with mohurs. As you can see in this picture, so many mohurs are there. The workers were overjoyed. They all were very happy because it was really unexpected. Nobody thought of such a gift. They said that this was a gift of Shivaji from the goddess Bhavani, who had blessed his efforts. People said that goddesses Bhavani has gifted this gift to Shivaji Maharaj for the welfare of the Swaraj. All the money discovered was brought to Shivaji. Shivaji felt greatly elated at this unexpected gift, which would enable him to pursue his deal of Swaraj with added vigor. He felt that was working under the benevolent eye of the goddess Bhavani. Now, the workers the soldiers of Shivaji Maharaj were very much honest. How we can say that? Because whatever money was discovered there, not a single person thought of taking anything from it. All the money discovered was brought to Shivaji Maharaj. No one thought of taking anything from it for himself, because after all, it was the wealth of Swaraj. Now the next important thing was how to utilize this treasure. It was unexpected treasure, and they wanted to buy weapons from this. So Shivaji utilized part of the treasure found in the fort to purchase arms and ammunition, means the weapons. The rest he decided to use for another project which was already in his hand. Now, he already captured one fort. Now he was planning for the other thing. About 15 kilometers to the east of Torana is the hill of Murumdev. Now Shivaji had his eye on it for a long time. Murumdev hill was a steep and difficult to access and therefore of great strategic importance. Adil Shah had actually started constructing a fort on this hill but had left it unfinished. He already started constructing but he left it unfinished. So what happened? There also it was very less soldiers were there, very less ammunitions were there. So this hill was also not well guarded and Shivaji decided to capture it also. It was 15 kilometers to the east of Torana. So this became the capital of Swaraj. How? One day Shivaji climbed up the hill with select band of his followers and took possession of the partially completed fort. The fort was not completely prepared, but partially it was ready. The money found on Torana was used to complete the fortification of Murumdev. And Shivaji named this fort Rajgad. Now, whatever money they found in the Torana fort, the mohurs they found, they utilized it in the fortification of Murumdev because it was incomplete. And Shivaji named this fort Rajgad. Stone masons, carpenters, blacksmiths, water carriers, and other all the workers, all the people got very busy in the building of this fortification. They built the Rajmahal, Bara Mahal, and 18 workshops. Rajgad became the first capital of Swaraj. Now, as we can see, Shivaji was progressing very rapidly. At first, he captured the Torana fort, and then next he captured the Murumdev hill, and he decided to make a fort over there and did the fortification. The whole country known as Bara Mawal, the 12 Mawlas, was overflowing with joy and excitement. The Patils and Deshmukhs from many villages came and swore allegiance to Shivaji. Now, so many people were jealous of Shivaji Maharaj that he is progressing rapidly. But the Mawal had its own share of blacklegs who were very ever ready to put a spoke in the fast moving wheel of Swaraj. Because Shivaji was companioned by the Mawlas who were very much honest and loyal to Shivaji Maharaj, so Shivaji Maharaj did not bother about other people. What happened? Jealous of Shivaji's success, they complained to the Adilshahi collector at Shivral. The people, those who were very much jealous of Shivaji's success and progress, what they did, they went to Adilshahi collector at Shivral and they complained about Shivaji that Shivaji is growing rapidly. And what happened? That collector, he went to Adil Shah. The collector dispatched messengers to Bijapur and informed Adil Shah about the Shivaji's rapid progress. So do you think what Adilsha will feel? How Adilsha was feeling that time? Was he happy? After knowing that Shivaji Maharaj is rapidly. Yes, Soham?
Sad.
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 He was sad and also angry.
Angry.
Right? How he can make such progress? So as some of the students said, he was sad, was angry because he was the Adilsha, he was Sultan from that area. At first, he was very much surprised that what is going on, how he can capture all this fort. He asked Shahaji Raje for an explanation, like how Shivaji is capturing all the fort. You give me an explanation. So Shahaji Raje got himself out of this difficult situation by telling the Sultan that Shivaji Raje had probably taken over the fort for better administration of Jagir. Shivaji also sent this message to the Sultan. Now Shahaji Raje told Adilsha that Shivaji is not capturing your fort for any bad purpose, but he is helping you for the better administration. Shivaji's message was, I have taken possession of the fort for better administration of the countryside. We did this only in the interest of the Sultan. There was no evil design at the back of this action. This was the message of Shivaji Maharaj, which was sent to Adilsha, that we are not capturing your fort for any bad purpose or for just holding our, increasing our Swaraj, but we are doing it for your purpose only, for helping you and for the better administration of the countryside. So Adilsha did not mind it. He did not pay much attention because he thought that Shivaji is now young and he cannot capture such forts. So he is just doing a favor for me. So Adilsha did not mind it. But Shivaji has other future plans also. The forts, two forts of Konana and Purandar too had strategic locations. So now Shivaji's eye was on these two forts. Shivaji used his political skill and took control of both the forts. Firstly, he started with Torana Fort. Then he captured the hill Murumdev and made a first capital named as Rajgarh. And Rajgarh became the first capital. After on, he also had his eyes on Kondana Fort and Purandar Fort. He took control of all these forts also. The next fort to come under his eye way was Rohida. So this was fast work indeed, and there was nothing to stop Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji was going very rapidly, capturing all the important forts and establishing Swaraj in the Maharashtra rapidly, sometimes gradually. But it was firm for the Mavlas and for all the people that now it is confirmed that the Swaraj will be established and rule of the people will prevail. Okay, I want all of you to pay attention again one more time for the evaluation. We will start with fill in the blanks. The first fill in the blank is Shivaji controlled the Jagir of Pune, Supe, Chakan and Dash.
Indapur.
Okay, very good. So the answer is Indapur. Shivaji controlled the Jagir of Pune, Supe, Chakan and Indapur. Number two is Shivaji decided to capture the fort of Dash and lay the foundation of Hindavi Swaraj, which was that was captured by Shivaji Maharaj.
Torana.
Torana.
Torana. Torana Fort.
तो शिवाजी डिसाइडेड टू कैप्चर द फोर्ट ऑफ तोरणा एंड ले द फाउंडेशन ऑफ हिंदवी स्वराज. गुड. नंबर थ्री इज डैश बिकेम द फर्स्ट कैपिटल ऑफ स्वराज. राजगढ़ बिकेम द फर्स्ट कैपिटल ऑफ स्वराज. नेक्स्ट वी हैव राइट द आंसर इन वन सेंटेंस. आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर वन क्वेश्चन. विच फोर डिफरेंट पावर्स गवर्न महाराष्ट्र इन दोज डेज.
मोगल एम्प्लॉयर ऑफ दिल्ली, नादिर शाह ऑफ बीजापुर, सिटी ऑफ जंजीरा, पोर्टुगीज ऑफ गोवा.
ओके, एनीबॉडी एल्स वांट टू आंसर? यस यू कैन ट्राई, आई विल हेल्प यू सोहम.
महाराष्ट्र वाज कॉल्ड बाय फोर डिफरेंट पावर्स.
Which are the powers? First was Adil Shah. Okay.
Maharashtra was governed by four different powers. The Mughal employer of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, the Portuguese of Goa, and the Siddhi of Janjira.
Very nice, Aditi. Very good. So hum pay attention here. All of you see the answer. Maharashtra was governed by four different powers. That is the Mughal Emperor of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, Portuguese of Goa, and the Siddhi of Janjira. These are the four powers that governed Maharashtra during that time. Next, we have got the picture, and you have to identify this picture.
God is Torandai.
Okay.
God is Torandai.
On which fort the temple was there?
Torana fort.
Yes. In the Torana fort, there was a temple of Goddess Torandai, and the fort was named after Goddess Torandai only. Very good. In assignment, you have to make a fort using clay. You can use mud also. I will show you one example. Here the fort is prepared with the help of mud and cardboard. They are colored and decorated. And the small flags are put on the top of the fort. And another is also example. It is made up of clay. Like this, you have to prepare fort for your assignment. And you can submit it in the group. Okay. Thank you, children, for your wonderful participation.